You might know this feeling. You start watching a Langchain tutorial and they keep using OpenAI, but you don't want to spend money. So in this video, I will show you first how you can reduce your costs if you're working with OpenAI, and second, three ways how to load local free models from Huggingface so you don't have to pay any money anymore. So if you're interested in that, then keep watching.
Let's start talking about numbers every LLM developer should know. We're not developing LLMs, but we're using them, and we still need to know some of these numbers, especially if we want to use them locally. So if you're working with OpenAI or any other API which costs you some money per token or per 1000 tokens, if you construct your prompts in a way where you tell the model to be concise, you can reduce your cost by 40 to 90%. And also, per word, in average, you need 1.3 tokens. So 1000 tokens would be approximately 750 words. So if we go over to the OpenAI tokenizer, you can see the word tokenization already has 2 tokens. That's an example. So you have to keep in mind, one word does not equal 1 token. Okay, now let's talk about the actual important part, GPU memory. I will present you 3 ways to load local LLMs, but let's talk about the numbers first. You have to think about, if a model has 7 billion parameters, the GPU memory needed to load the model is 2 times the parameter size. So it would be 14 gigabytes of VRAM. And why is that so? Because we have to know how these parameters are stored. So we have float 32. Float 32 would be 4 bytes per parameter. And usually for fine-tuning models, they work with float 16. So 2 bytes per parameter, which means, as we calculated already, for 7 billion parameters, there has to be 14 gigabytes. But this means if I would want to load a 7 billion parameter model on my local machine, I don't have that much VRAM, but there's a method how we can still load those large language models of these large sizes, and I will tell you about it. So let's hop over to VS Code. Okay, here you can see on left side I have some tracking enabled of my GPU memory usage. Also, you can see I have here 3 files prepared for you how to load those models. So here's the base version, how you can load the local LLMs. And all 3 files are constructed in the same manner. I have to create prompt, which is basically the same. I create LLM or LLM pipeline, create the chain, and then here just load the chain and keep the question answering running. We're working with models from Hugging Face. You can easily, from langchain.llms, load the Hugging Face pipeline, call from model ID, enter the model ID parameter, decide which device. I'm going to try to load it on my GPU. Let's try to load the 3 billion parameter model, and then we will look at the memory usage. Okay, here you see something interesting. The model has 3 billion parameters, which estimates to, if we take a time 2, 6 gigabytes. But I don't know if there are exactly 3 billion. In this case, there might be some more. There might be 3.5 billion. So we can see here it spiked and it tops out, so it can't be loaded in my memory. Even the 3 billion parameter model is too much to load on GPU. So we could load it on the CPU right now, but I want to show the GPU version. So what are we doing now? There is the method called quantization. What is quantization? Quantization basically does some mathematical operations to store the 16-bit parameters into 8-bit parameters or even 4-bit parameters. Okay, let's talk about the first quantization technique, bits and bytes. It basically quantizes the model on the fly. You can load every Hugging Face model and it quantizes it to load it in 8-bit or in 4-bit. But there's a drawback to this method. It's a CUDA wrapper, so all the models have to be loaded on the GPU. You can't use this method with the CPU. Therefore, we have to load it in another way. So here, with the base method, we could just simply run the Hugging Face pipeline from model ID. But with bits and bytes, we have to load the model first from AutoModel for Causal LM, from pre-trained, and then enter it in the Transformers pipeline. And then we can enter this pipeline in the Hugging Face pipeline, because the Hugging Face pipeline has this device parameter. And if we directly would load the bits and bytes version in the Hugging Face pipeline, then this causes an error, because it tells us you can only run it on the GPU, therefore you can't define a device parameter. And because of that, we have to load it in this way. Okay, so let's actually test it out. So let's load it in 8-bit first. We're going to see it started above 1 gigabyte, and now we hop to 4.5. So 3.5, yeah, seems that 3.5 billion parameters, 3.5 gigabytes. Let's test it. And also note another thing, when the inference runs, it takes some more GPU memory to generate generate the output. You can see it works, but maybe the prompt template has to be tweaked a little bit, but that's not what this is about right now. So let's load it in 4-bit, and we should see that it approximately should only take half of the GPU memory. Yeah, the kettle of friends pair is perfect. Here, for example, you could also bind to the stop the double break line. Let's try to say it again. The kettle of friends pair is so it stopped the generation of the output when the two new lines got detected. So the interesting part, the people who invented this method, who wrote the paper, they said that there's basically not much performance impairment. You can see here the inference speed is a little bit slower, but the actual, let's say, accuracy or generation quality remains almost the same. So this is a really good method. If you have enough GPU memory, you can load the models in this manner and still have very good generation results. But what if you don't have a GPU, if you want to load it on a CPU? There is another method how you can load it, and I will talk about it right now. Langchain C transformers. So here over at Huggingface again, at the bloke, he's uploading multiple models which are trained with the quantization methods. So we have different quantization methods here: AWQ, GPTQ, GGUF, then there's also GGML somewhere. But don't be confused by all those names. These are just different methods to quantize the models from different people who wrote the papers. What we have to know is that these models are specifically fine-tuned in that way, and the parameters are stored, and we can directly load the models which have been fine-tuned in these ways. So for example, let's see the 7 billion parameter model. Here are different quantization methods, even 2-bit quantization, it seems, 3-bit, 4-bit, 5-bit, 6-bit and 8-bit. So you can see here how many RAM is required to work with these models. And now let's hop over to VS Code again, and I will show you how we load these models. So you can load these models with the C transformers library from Langchain directly. I downloaded the Mistral 7 billion parameter with 4-bit quantization method, and we can easily load it with C transformers, enter the model path and the model type, and that's it already. The prompt and the chain are the same. So let's load it, C transformers, and we will see that the GPU stays the same. It gets loaded in my RAM memory, and we will run it on the CPU right now. Also, it's pretty fast. Yeah, I mean, this is not on the GPU, which typically is faster than CPU, that's on the CPU, and the result is really fast. So who are you? So this is a really nice method to get amazing large language models like the 7 billion Mistral model run on your local machine without having to use a lot of GPU memory. There's also a way where you can run it on a GPU, but as you can see, the results are really good, and it's also really fast on the CPU. This concludes the three methods: how to load the models locally, how to use quantization. If you want me to go deeper in the quantization methods, talk about different methods, explain the math behind it a little bit, write it in the comments and I will make a video about it. We didn't even scratch the surface here. We just talked about how to load these models, but there's so much more behind that. So I hope you could learn something. I will give you the code. Look in the link in the description, then you can play around with it yourself. I will also link a lot of references in the description where you can read up on the quantization methods if you want to read up on it yourself. I hope you like this video. Click the like button, click the subscribe button, and see you in the next video.